गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग।
पापा।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
कैसे पढ़ गया पापा? हम
लोग जितने लंबे रेस्ट कर रहे हैं।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। Math class was over?
Yes, sir.
Bye, David.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Good morning. You have to join very quickly by 11. Or if you want, I can begin. I can begin by 11:05 because all of you have to join quickly. Zoom gives only 40 minutes time for us. And somehow I don't know. I am unable to take class on Google Classroom. So that's and it is better have class on Zoom because. There is a recording facility on Zoom. I can send you the links. I can upload the classes on YouTube and I can send you the links. You can listen to my lecture anytime. Shall you do that?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
I will upload every class on YouTube and send you the link and you can watch anytime. That is possible only if I take class on Zoom. Not on Google Classroom. We don't have recording facility on Google Classroom. Now 42 have joined. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
48, 47. Okay. Let us quickly go through what we have learned so far. The second lesson we are going to complete today and we are going to begin the third lesson also. Third means 22nd. The first lesson was obligation. What was the first lesson? Expressing obligation. In that we learned four expressions. Must, should, basically three expressions only, must, should, and have to. These are the three expressions we learned in obligation. Must is, you must do it, it is the law, there is no choice. You should, there is a choice, it is a suggestion. You should do it means you have a choice, it is only a suggestion. Should means it is better to do. And have to is when you have an external obligation. And when you don't like, you have to use have to. These are the expressions we learned. But let us quickly go through what we have learned so far. And we have rewritten these sentences. You remember, can you quickly go through these sentences and read out with using must and should or have to? I really need to get a haircut. I must get a haircut. I strongly.
I really need to get a haircut. I have to get a haircut.
I strongly recommend you to watch this movie.
You should watch this movie.
I have to watch this movie. You should recommend you to watch this movie.
It is not important to
work.
It is not important to work. You must finish your work. You have to enjoy your work in the classroom.
You must wear a helmet when you ride a bike.
You have to finish your work in
the classroom.
You must enjoy your
You must finish
your work in time. Enjoy your work.
Now you know the difference between must, should, and have to very clearly. You can use those three expressions. And then we began fixing and canceling appointments. We went through some dialogues between receptionist and Kiran Kumar. Rescheduling an appointment, fixing an appointment, canceling an appointment, rescheduling an appointment. We went through these things and we did some activities also. Please read this slide quickly.
We make appointments both in personal and work study terms. Fixing appointments in advance, avoid both appointments. And
it is equally important to agree to inform the other party. Some reason you are unable to keep the appointment. If you need to reschedule an appointment to a later date or time, you should put that in advance of the meeting so as not to waste other people's time.
And now, expressions used to fix an appointment. This slide is very important. This is a very important slide. Expressions used to fix an appointment. How about meeting on the 30th of August? How about coming tomorrow? How about having a class tomorrow? See, how about, that is the expression. How about, will you be free? How does so and so sound? Shall we say, can I Friday be convenient? Could you please? I would like to meet. These are very important expressions. You should remember them. Can you use these expressions in your own sentences quickly? Quickly, you please read out. Read out the expressions and your own sentences. How about having lunch together? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
How about having lunch together? It is also fixing an appointment. That means, shall we have lunch together?
Yes, sir. Can.
Yeah, read the other expressions also. Hello.
Will you be free?
Second floor, Bogaltara. I'm going to invite you. Yeah, will you be?
Will you be free on 5th March?
No, use a different sentence. Free, forget about free. Will you be available?
Will you tomorrow? Be available?
What is the meaning of will you be available tomorrow? Will you be available tomorrow means?
You will be there tomorrow
or not.
You are fixing an appointment with that person tomorrow. Will you be available tomorrow? Why are we asking? Enduku adugutunnam? Will you be available untara ani enduku adugutunnam?
To fix an appointment with them.
Fix an appointment, okay? Will you be available tomorrow? Will you be in Hyderabad tomorrow? Why? Because I want to meet you tomorrow. Yeah, to fix an appointment. I want to meet you tomorrow. How does the 3rd of June sound? How does the afternoon sound? How about meeting in the afternoon? Shall we say tomorrow? Shall we meet on Sunday? Shall we have lunch together tomorrow? See, read all the sentences again aloud. You have to be able to use these sentences, these expressions in your own sentences. Please read aloud, read aloud, read all the expressions aloud as if you are speaking. Are you listening to me?
Yes, sir.
Are you reading all the sentences?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then we did this one, this activity we did yesterday, I mean in the last class. And this one also we did, request the receptionist of St. Martha's Hospital. We did this one. General Hospital, request the receptionist at General Hospital to reschedule the appointment. Rescheduling, this is scheduling, fixing an appointment. This is rescheduling. And this is, what is this? This is also rescheduling. And now today we have to do this one. Come on, go through it and write a dialogue. Your boss wants you to write this activity in your notebook and write a dialogue. Your boss wants you to go to.
Sir, I want to rejoin again. Please allow me, sir.
Please. You can rejoin. Your boss wants you to go to Nizamabad to inspect the branch office there. Inform your friend that you cannot accept his invitation for dinner. So now what is the situation? Please read the activity you are supposed to do. Read, understand, and tell me what are you supposed to do. Yes, your boss wants you to go to Nizamabad to inspect the branch office there. Inform your friend that you cannot accept his invitation.
We have to inform our friend that we are unable to attend the invitation for dinner.
Yes, right. Your friend has invited you for dinner. But you can't attend his dinner because you have to go to Nizamabad to inspect a branch office there. Okay? Now write a dialogue between you and your friend. Yes, have you begun writing the dialogue? Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, have you written any dialogue between you and your friend? Very simple, you have to inform your friend that you can't go to his house to eat dinner. Yes, why are you taking so much of time to give just one diagram?
So we have to mention our friend name also, sir.
No, you have to. Yeah, you can mention. There's nothing wrong. You can write the write two names, your friend's name and your name. You can write Sujata is your friend and myself. You can write like this, and you can give the dialogue between your friend Sujata and you. Who wants to speak?
Tanmay, sir.
Tanmay, yeah. Come on, speak.
Me, hello. Friend, hi, how are you? Me, I am good. I call you for informing that I cannot accept your invitation for dinner. Friend, but why? Me, my boss assigned me a work. Friend, what is that work? Is that very important? Me, yes, it is important. My boss wants me to go to Nizamabad to inspect the branch office there. Friend, oh fine, it's okay, carry on. Me, thank you. Friend, okay, bye. Me, bye.
Right, very good, very good. Nice dialogue. Anybody else?
So I'm Swati, sir.
Yeah, Swati.
Me, good morning, Mamata. Mamata, good morning, Swati. Me, if you don't mind, I want to say something. Mamata, yes, please, friend, you can say. I'm not coming to dinner, Mamata. Why? Me. I have some work. My boss has said me to go to Nizamabad, inspire the branch office there. Mamata. It is important? Yes, it is important. Okay, carry on. Me. Okay, bye.
Right, very good. One more person. Yeah, there are many, many, many. Jyoti, Tejaswini. Who is Jyoti? 14, Jyoti is there?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you give me your dialogue, Jyoti?
I'm still writing, sir.
No, just to write one dialogue, how much time does it take? You have to practice writing, Jyoti. You have to see. We don't know when we are going to have classes in college. COVID-19 is increasing every day. Yesterday, there were around 1,000 cases in our Telangana. So we have to make use of our online classes completely. Please don't relax. And you have another burden. You did not write first semester's exams. And second semester is going on. Simultaneously, you have tried first semester exams and second semester exams. We don't know when it is going to happen. Okay? Please.
Okay, sir.
Gaganashri. Gaganashri is there or not? Is not there, Gaganashri? Are you not there? It means some of you are just switching on the mobile phones and not attending classes. I will call all of you. Please give me your attendance. Sandhya Rani, 47.
Sir, I am Gaganashri.
I am Gaganashri. You are there?
Yes, sir.
Can you please give me your sentences?
What,
you have
sir?
To inform your friend that you cannot accept his invitation for dinner. Instead of his, you can say her. Why is it taking so much of time, Gaganashri? Tejaswini, 37. Ishrat, 27. Thirty-four, Anugya. Three, Ashmita or Ashmita? What is the name? Aishwarya, 51. Nobody is responding. That means none of you are present. You just switched on your mobile phones and you are not there in the class.
So 51.
51, yeah. Please give me your dialogue.
Me, hello, Geeta. Geeta, hello, Aishwarya. Me, I cannot I can't come for dinner today. Geeta, why, what is the reason, Aishwarya? Me, my boss has said to inspect the branch of Nizamabad office. Geeta, oh, okay, it's okay. Me, okay, Geeta, thank you.
Right, very good. Bhargavi, 8. Nikita Kalyani.
Hello, sir. I'm Anusha, sir.
You are?
Anusha, sir.
Yeah, Anusha.
Me. Hello, Shivajyoti. How are you? Friend. Hello, Anusha. Fine. What about you? Me. Fine. And one thing I'm saying, I'm not attending the invitation for dinner. Friend. Okay, but bye. Me. I'm go to the Nizamabad to inspect the branch of office there. Friend. Okay. Carry on. Me. Okay. Thank you. Friend. Welcome.
Okay, right, very good. That's all. That is what you are supposed to do. You just have to write a dialogue between the other person and you. Now there is another activity you have to do quickly. Everybody please note down in your notebook. Whenever we meet in the class in college, I will check whether you have written all these things in your notebook or not, because most of you are not responding. I don't know whether you are there attending class or just switched on your mobile and left. You cannot meet your teacher to discuss your final year project, as you have to take your grandmother to hospital. This is what you are supposed to do now. What do? You cannot meet your teacher to discuss your final year project, as you have to take your grandmother to hospital. First, you understand this sentence. Write this sentence in your notebook. Understand it. And then write the dialogue. And speak. If you can speak directly, you can speak instead of writing. Yes, come on, quick. What's the activity? Have you understood the activity? What are you supposed to do?
The dialogue between me and teachers.
Yes, right.
So I'm Swati, so shall I sing?
Yeah, some people are speaking regularly and the others also have to speak. If the others can't speak, then you can speak.
Okay, sir.
Yes. Grishma?
Sir?
Okay, have you written the dialogue?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please read the dialogue.
Me. Good morning, ma'am. Teacher. Very good morning. Ma'am, I cannot meet you to discuss our final year project. Teacher, it's okay, but why? I have to take my grandmother to the hospital for getting checkup. Teacher, okay, no problem. We can postpone it. Thank you, ma'am.
Right, very good. Next, who else? Srilekha?
Writing, sir.
Kaveri. Abhinaya. Akhila Banu. Padmavati. Yeah, I am going on calling your names, but you are not responding. Maithili.
Sir, can I say, sir, Padmavati?
Padmavati, yeah. Please.
Me. Hello, ma'am. I am Padmavati. Ma'am, hello. Me. Ma'am, I cannot meet you to discuss about the final year project. Ma'am, may I know the reason? Me. I should take my grandmother to hall for checkup. Ma'am, okay, let's discuss about the project at another time. Me. Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Madam, bye.
Right. Okay. Then I think we have a number of activities to do. Now, extending and accepting invitations. Extending and accepting invitations. This is the next lesson. You can write the title of the lesson. Extending and accepting invitations. Not fixing and canceling appointments. The first lesson in second semester was obligation. Second lesson was fixing and canceling appointments. And this is the third one in second semester, extending and accepting invitations. How do you extend means? Extending invitation means inviting somebody. When do we invite somebody?
When there is some
when?
There is any occasion.
Yeah. Yeah. Festivals, personal place, marriage or birthday party. Or homes or home ceremony.
Yeah, yeah. When there is occasion. Usually when there is an occasion, when there is a festival or when there is a function, we invite. Do we not invite others when there is no function at all at our home?
Yes, we can invite, sir.
Yeah, sometimes we can invite just
for dinner or something else.
Yeah, please come to dinner to our house. You can invite even when there is no occasion. Usually we invite when there is an occasion, but sometimes even when there is no occasion, we can invite our friends or our relatives. Should invitation be oral or written?
Written, sir. Sometimes it will be
sometimes oral or sometimes
like oral, maybe oral or written.
Yeah, both. Sometimes it is oral or sometimes it is written. When is
for
it oral?
For kumkum ceremony, it is oral.
When is it oral and when is it written?
Oral is for something kumkum ceremony, or written is for marriage or birthday parties.
Yeah, when there is an occasion, usually when there is an occasion, we send written invitation. We give written invitation. Suppose there is a marriage in our family, we get invitation card printed, that is written or printed. Okay. But when there is no occasion, come to our house tomorrow evening, just that is, we can give oral invitation. Okay. Now then, just small activity, give a sentence or two inviting your teacher to a farewell party. Write a sentence inviting your teacher to a farewell party. You did that some 15 days back. Did you do it or not?
Yes, sir.
You didn't do it?
Yes, sir. So yeah. We have to say this in sentence or like conversation?
Yeah, conversation. Give a sentence or two. Sentence or two inviting your teacher. It is not a written invitation. It is oral invitation. You have come to me to my room. And you are inviting me to the farewell party. How do you invite me?
So shall I say, sir, Swati?
Yeah, okay, come on.
Hi, ma'am, good morning. We are having a farewell party. Can you please come, ma'am?
Thank you, ma'am.
No, okay, it is not bad. But is it really, you are talking to your elders? Can you please, which is better? Can you please, or please come, or can you please come? Which is
sir,
better?
Shall I say it 1 second?
Yeah, 1 second, please.
Sir, Harini, can I, sir?
Yeah.
Sir. Good morning, sir. This is Harini from Tribly branch. Sir, good morning, dear. What's the reason? Me. Sir, we have planned to have a farewell party tomorrow afternoon. Can you please come, sir? Sir, yes, sure, dear. Why not? Thank you, sir. Sir, welcome.
Right. Okay. Both are correct. Can you please come? Can you please come? Instead of can you please, you better say could you please. I think I already told you, could is more polite than can. Could you please come, sir? Could you please come? Okay. Right. Okay. Now, very good. And then, read this dialogue, please.
Mahi. Hello, Gauri. How are you? Gauri. Hi. It's been so long since we meet. How are you? Any special occasion coming up? Mahi. Yes, my brother's marriage has been fixed. Gauri. Convey my congratulations to him. When is the wedding? Mahi. It's on 10th of the next month. Here is your invitation. Gauri. Oh, the marriage is on Sunday. Mahi. Please do come. If you let me know your travel details, I'll make the necessary arrangements. Gauri, thank you for the invitation. I'll definitely be there.
Yeah, right. This is a sample dialogue between two friends, right? Mahi and Gauri are two friends. Now you have to, what is the activity you are supposed to do? You have to identify the phrases used to extend and accept invitations. Which are the expressions? Extending invitation and accepting invitation.
Extending invitation.
Yeah. I think only in the last dialogue of Mahi, you have invitation.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Last. Please do come.
Yeah, Mahi, please do come.
If you let me know your travel details, I will make the necessary arrangements.
Okay. Now the expression extending invitation is please do come. Please do come. That's all. Okay. What is the meaning of please come? Difference between please come and please do come? Anybody? Does anybody know the difference between please come and please do come? Please come on TNT. Please do come on TNT. Please do come on TNT. Tappakunda rammani ardham. Do come means tappakunda randi. Please come on TNT randi. Do ane word pettinatayite before any verb, it is certainly tappakunda. Please do submit your assignment.
Okay, sir.
Please do submit your rubrics notebook by tomorrow. Means a must. Adamenda? Please do come. Please remember this. How is Gauri accepting the invitation?
Thanks for the invitation.
Thanks for the invitation. Right. Thanks for the invitation.
I'll definitely be there.
Yeah, I'll definitely be there. Thanks for the invitation. I will definitely be there. Now, write this activity in your notebook and bring a dialogue tomorrow. Now we have only 1 minute time. we are going to get disconnected. Our class is going to end within a minute. So write this activity and bring a dialogue tomorrow. You have to show me your notebook. Your friend has invited you to his sister's wedding. How do you accept the invitation? Speak out your sentences.
Okay, these sentences, sir. You are going to.
So I'm Swati, so shall I see?
Yeah, you can. And you, this is your homework for tomorrow. You have to bring it, bring the dialogue. Now, Swati, you can say.
Pooja, hello.